Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Tushar Mehta, an orthopedic surgeon and a faculty of orthopedics at DAMS. So I'm starting a clinical case series in which we will be discussing clinical cases with their clinico-radiological input. We will try to correlate right from the basic sciences till the final year subjects. And in that series, here is our case number one. All right, so we do have an 8-year-old child. He's a boy, and he is presenting with pain, and that too in the right shoulder, and the duration is very small. It has last few days. Now there is no history of fever. All right, he denies any trauma as well. On clinical examination, it is slightly tender to palpation. Blood counts show mildly elevated ESR, that's all. So guys, before I go further, let's try to accumulate what we have right till now. So it's a child, it's a boy, the pathology is somewhere in the shoulder, the history is short, there is pain. Apart from that, they have not mentioned any rise in fever or any redness. They have categorically mentioned that there is no fever, so I take my mind slightly away from infection. They deny history of fall, so I'm going a little away from trauma as well. Now it is tender to palpation. Okay, fine. Counts show mildly elevated ESR, so again I'm going slightly away from infection. X-ray is awaited. Alright, now let's see this X-ray. Now, when you see this X-ray, you are definitely going to see a lesion. The lesion is in the proximal humerus. Agreed. The lesion is not involving the epiphysis. The lesion is not involving the physis of the growth plate. The lesion is primarily in the metaphysis. Primarily in the metaphysis as such, might have an extent towards the diaphysis, but primarily it is in the metaphysis as such. And I can definitely note this area of cortical break. So I would say it's a lesion in the metaphysis of the proximal humerus in an 8-year-old boy without any other signs of trauma or signs of infection, with a pathological fracture of the cortex. Everything takes me towards simple bone cyst, solitary bone cyst, unicameral bone cyst. Now, what simple bone cyst is all about? As I told you, also called as unicameral bone cyst, it's a typically benign lesion of an unknown etiology. It's still not very clear. They are always unilocular. There's a single loculated cavity usually. It's a cystic lesion, and then as the name suggests, it's a cyst. Now we will be talking about certain statistical figures. It is primarily seen in children, and you can also see it in early adolescents. Boys are definitely more commonly involved as compared to girls. Now, please try to understand that it mainly involves the metaphysis. It mainly involves the metaphysis, and it mainly involves the children. Before the epiphyseal fusion or before the skeletal maturity, we see most of the cases. But yes, we do see certain cases in adults, primarily when they occur in the lower limb bones and that the tarsal bones like calcaneum and talus. SBC of calcaneum is very, I will not say very common, but very well noted amongst various, articles on the internet. So these people are usually not children or early adolescent, they're usually adults. So boys are more commonly involved, kids are usually involved. Most common location is always the metaphyseal area. Now it might extend up to diaphysis, but usually it is seen in metaphysis, always located within the medullary canal. And there are many sites I've already mentioned, but let me tell you, my dear students, that you should remember the most common site, which is proximal humerus. Even in my career till now, I've seen majority of the cases, they were in proximal humerus. Then femur and long bone, and I don't care about them because they're not that important. But yes, you do see them, calcaneum and talus, but what is the catch here? That usually these people will be adults, and they will not be the typical usual kids. Sleeping lions, don't touch them. They are usually seen asymptomatic. Simple bone cyst usually does not present with any symptoms. So they are usually asymptomatic, and probably that is why they are more of an incidental diagnosis. I will share a clinical case. An 8-year-old boy, something different from this. An 8-year-old boy never had any symptom. He had some fever. He had some congestion. He was referred to a physician. That chest physician got a chest X-ray done. In that chest X-ray, while he was looking at the lung fields, he noted that something is there, or just slightly outside the lung fields, and he noted that there is some lesion inside the proximal humerus, for which he referred it to an orthopedic surgeon. There was no complaint of pain, there was no other complaint, and it was an incidental diagnosis. A physician got an X-ray done, and on which it was seen. But yes, it can be symptomatic, as we discussed. It can have pain, it can have swelling, it can have stiffness of the distant joint. But my dear students, please try to understand the way I have told you that majority of the cases are seen in metaphysis of the proximal humerus. Please do remember that majority of the cases of simple bones, they present only with pathological fracture. That is a usual presenting complaint. This is what they usually present to you. I hope that makes sense to all of you. The one that we have discussed in this particular patient as well. Now, what is the basic pathology like? See, what is cyst? You have to understand, right? What is cyst? Cyst is a fluid-filled cavity. So this has to contain clear fluid. This has to contain clear liquid, simple. But yes, if the simple bone cyst is complicated by a fracture, then that simple clear fluid will have certain tinge of blood in it. Very simple. So usually an SBC will have a simple clear fluid. But if it is having a pathological fracture, it can be blood tinged. And I told you, what is a cyst? So a cyst is a fluid-filled cavity. It's a fluid-filled cavity which is lined by a thin layer of connective tissue. Simple. Now, what about the further investigations? I would say plain X-ray. That is the most helpful, which we have seen, and I will now describe that plain X-ray. Apart from that, you can go for a CT, you can go for an MRI, you can go for a bone scan. But normally, we don't require that. Now, X-ray, what are the classical features on an X-ray? A well-defined central translucency. The keyword here is central translucency. So in the center, I'll show you, in the center you have a translucency. Metaphyseal area, mostly involved, but it can extend up to the diaphyseal area as well. The most important point is that well-defined central translucency is surrounded by a very, very thinned out cortex. Very, it's just a papyrus, paper thin cortex surrounding that central translucency. And the most important part is that you won't see any periosteal reaction. Hardly any periosteal reaction will be seen, unless and until a fracture occurs. You want to see this? Okay, we'll show you one more side. This is not that routine proximal humerus that you always see. This is the proximal femur. So it's a classical central radiolucency in the metaphyseal, diaphyseal to an extent area, which is surrounded by a very much thinned out papyraceous cortex without almost negligible periosteal reaction that happens usually whenever it is associated with a pathological fracture, as I've already told you. You want to see another X-ray? We have another X-ray for you. You can see this as well. So probably you can see that this is the lower end of the radius. You can see it is not epiphyseal, it is not physeal, it is metaphyseal, having some extent in the diaphyseal area as well. My dear students, you can very well see the thinned out cortex. You can see the translucency classically there. Alright, you can see that without hardly any periosteal reaction. Alright, so this is simple bone cyst for you. Now, this is another simple bone cyst. I thought that I should include a simple bone cyst of calcaneum as well. And I have already told you that people usually who are having simple bone cysts of these areas, they are usually adults. You can see everything. So categorically included, not only a simple bone cyst of the proximal humerus, but of the femur, but of the lower end of the radius, and then of calcaneum as well. Now, what is a fallen leaf sign, or what is a fallen fragment sign? See, a simple bone cyst complicates into a pathological fracture. Then that bony fragment becomes dependent, just like a leaf, alright? So you have a stem like this, and you have got a leaf like this. So now what is going to happen if it gets broken down? If the leaf gets broken down, probably you are going to have something like this. So now this leaf, after getting broken down from there, it becomes dependent. So that dependent part of the bone is what is called as fallen leaf sign or fallen fragment sign. You can very well see that. So this piece of the bone, all right, this piece of the bone which you can see here as actually become the most dependent part after getting fallen from that area. So fallen leaf sign or fallen fragment sign is classical of an SBC, which is complicated into pathological fracture. Do we get this? Now CT scan is again going to show you the same thing, you know, the less amount of cortical expansion, hardly any cortical, you know, thickening, it's majorly thinning, everything is the same. How do you treat? Now let me tell you guys, majority of the cases spontaneously resolve, to be very honest. At times we never get to know whether this patient is having SBC or not, because they occur on their own, the etiology is still not clear. Patients get the remaining symptomatic and close to skeletal maturity, the cyst wall collapses, the fluid dries up with the bone and everything is fine. But if you see a simple bone cyst, if it is that is symptomatic, I would say if it is asymptomatic, don't touch it. If it is asymptomatic, just wait and watch. If it is symptomatic, then we have a good option of injecting an intralesional steroid. So we take Canacort or we take this triamcinolone, we take methylprednisolone. Normally I prefer triamcinolone. And we inject that into the lesion. Sometimes we have to give repeated injections as well. Normally the cyst, see, you have to understand, I can give you something, you know, over hair, you know, coming from the directly in from my clinic, that what are steroids? Steroids are the best anti-inflammatory, and there's a very strong possibility of the people that, you know, they are considering simple bone cyst to be more of an inflammatory, less of a neoplastic lesion. And that is why I will not say that this has happened today, but this is going to probably happen soon, that people are going to remove simple bone cyst from the chapter of neoplasm and would be probably putting them under a chapter of unclassified bone etiology, because they're believing that the lesion is less of neoplastic in origin, but rather an inflammatory. The fluid that is accumulating inside is probably inflammatory in origin, and that is why anti-inflammatories are very good. And steroid, as we all know, is the best anti-inflammatory, and that is why any patient of simple bone cyst who is symptomatic, we first prefer a shot of steroids. And I've seen majority of them resolving. But yes, if it doesn't, if it reoccurs, then you have to be a little liberal. You will have to open it, you will have to curettage, and you will have to put a bone graft. So then you have to go radical, a bit radical. I'm not saying extensive surgery, but yes, bit of a surgery. But majority of the cases heal on their own. If not, then steroids are really helpful. What are the differential diagnoses? All cystic lesions, fibrous dysplasia, aneurysmal bone cyst, giant cell tumor, eosinophilic granuloma, non-ossifying fibroma, chordoma. All cystic lesions are differential diagnoses of simple bone cyst, but let me tell you, my dear students, that I get this very often, that sir, even now I get confused an SBC with an ABC. ABC aneurysmal bone cyst. See, this clinical case series is, you know, more about SBC, less about ABC, but still I'll give you a hint. Simple bone cyst can go from meta to diaphysis, ABC purely, typically in the metaphysis. In SBC, bone scan hardly shows you anything. But in ABC, guys, first of all, what is ABC? Aneurysmal bone cyst. What is aneurysm? Localized permanent abnormal dilatation of a blood vessel. You understand my point? So it has blood in it. Multiple capillaries developed small aneurysms and they coalesce together to make aneurysmal bone cyst. So that is why the CT is definitely going to show you a rich increase in vasculature and early venous filling, obviously. That is why CT findings are considered to be characteristic. The fluid levels are found to be characteristic of an ABC, while they are, you know, of no use in SBC. SBC, hardly any association, single solitary lesion, I told you. They are, ABC is usually associated with, you know, other tumors as well. This contains, I have told you, clear liquid and usually unilocular. This contains blood. I told you, aneurysm, blood vessel dilatation, so they have to contain blood. But yes, they do contain blood with giant cell. And probably, I know many of you might be aware of the fact that ABC is considered the closest giant cell variant. Okay, so they contain not only blood but with giant cell, and they are usually multilocular. I hope this table gives you a good insight that how do you differentiate an SBC or an ABC right from their location to their bone scan findings, to their CTMR findings, to their association, to their pathology of the cyst. This is a very beautiful table between SBC and ABC. All the, you know, first year PG, second year PG orthopedics, please guys note, this is something which will be asked from you in your viva. How do you differentiate SBC, ABC? and we'll be stuck up at just a couple of points, like, you know, age is almost similar, locations are almost similar, the site is almost similar, appearances are almost similar. So you will be stuck up in that. So it will be very clear: site, bone scan, CT, MRI, association, and pathology. In fact, I would like to show you an ABC also. Okay, so you can very well see the location, you know. You can very well see the multilocularity. You can very well see the blood-filled containing, you know, sinusoids, which are lined by these septa in between. You can very well see that. You can very well see the location is in metaphysis, just abutting the physis, just abutting the growth plate. All right, so now you see the difference between SBC and ABC. All right, they are unilocular. This is multilocular. You can very well see that. That contains fluid, simple, clear fluid. This contains blood-filled sinusoids that has no keratosis CD finding. This has, you know, fluid level. Why? Because of the presence of the blood. Then they have septum in between and they are multilocular. Of course, location is in metaphysis, just abutting the physis. This is purely ABC. All right, so with this, we come towards the end of this discussion. So carry home message. Kids usually resolve on their own. Boys are commonly involved. Most common location metaphysis are proximal femur, proximal humerus, usually asymptomatic. If at all they present with pathological fracture. X-ray shows central translucency with cortical thinning, with hardly any periosteal reaction. Treatment is usually conservative. Wait and watch for asymptomatic lesions. If it is symptomatic, then we give a shot of steroid. If it is recurrent, we bloody operate it as well. And I think that's a better option. There are many differential diagnoses, but one very important is ABC and how to differentiate between the two. We have discussed it. All right, so this was the first clinical case series, and I will be coming up with more short cases and probably some implants and instruments in the coming days to come. So keep watching. Have fun. Thank you.